It's your girl Simone Charisse, and today in this video, we are working with Diva Wigs. So I'm going to start off by just taking it out the box, showing you guys this nice, brown, lovely 360 lace frontal wig, okay? So you can definitely go ahead and put it in a ponytail and do as much styles as possible. So I'm going to do this trick that I've seen done on lace closures. It is not a new method, okay? It is a already done method, but I wanted to try it for a frontal because you guys know I just absolutely hate the ball cap method, but I will try it if you guys ask me. So I decided, you know what, this might be a little bit more breathable. Instead of keeping the whole entire wig on your head, I can just literally put on half of it, okay? And the rest of my head can still breathe. I don't have to feel like I'm stuck with this cap on my head for the entire week. So that's exactly what I did. I am gonna go ahead and just sew down the parts that I do wanna keep. Now, when it comes to a frontal, I don't really part by my ears. So that's why I kinda stopped. I kinda cut the rest of the cap off and I went up about 2 inches on each side. So go ahead and do the typical ball cap method. Melting your lace technique thing, use the gotta be glue, use the hairspray, and really just make sure it's dry, and then cut off the excess stocking cap. Now, when I was doing this, I was like, okay, what's a new way that I can make this comfortable for other people? Some people really just believe in this method. For me, I feel like I could wear a lace frontal wig, throw some foundation on the part, and to me it looks the same exact way. That's my opinion, but I'm all about comfort when it comes to my wigs. Like, I'm not gonna wear a stocking cap and a wig. Like, that's like two hats put together. So for me, I have to be comfortable. So I said this might be a little bit more doable for people who don't want to keep it on for so long, but they do want to go ahead. If they really believe in it, they still have the option to do the stocking cap for the parts where they will be doing their parting. So really spend time making sure that this cap is not rolled up. Make sure that it blends perfectly into your skin, which is what I'm doing now with the end of a rat tail comb. So this part is really important because if it is rolled up, you can see it underneath your lace, and girl, I will point it out if I see it, but it looks crazy. So make sure you spend time just really flattening out and unrolling the beginning of that ball cap. Next, I'm going to go ahead and use some Black Radiance powder foundation, really in my skin color. I didn't go lighter, I didn't go darker, and I really made sure I put it all over the front of my, on the ball cap. And then now I'm going to go ahead and just install the wig. Put it on your head, make sure it fits, cut by the ears, customize it to your liking, and pluck. I pluck this, but you can see the parting does look nice. It does match my skin. It is bright. And it does look more realistic, so if you like this method, go ahead and try it out. Let me know if it worked for you guys. Like I said, it's not new, but it's new to me, okay? And it's done for closures. It's usually put on closures. Closures usually have this so that it could look more natural, but I wanted to try it for a frontal. Okay, so this video, though, is really an experimentation video. This is my first time doing it. A lot of times, I like to do things on camera first, and then if I like it again, I'll do it again in another video, but you guys get to see the first reaction of how it really works. So I couldn't really see what I was doing because my mirror was so far from my table, so I couldn't really see what I was doing. So I was trying so hard to squint into my laptop that I have connected to my camera. So that's probably why I got a little bit more frustrated while doing this technique, but I just felt like it was so white around my hairline and it was driving me nuts. In this video, I am not mad. My dad was just drilling me about, he was on the phone on speaker, but at this point I was just like, I didn't know what to do. I was so frustrated, guys. Like, you can see it on my face. Like, I wanted to give up so bad, but I was trying my hardest not to. Like, this is what I always tell people. Like, if you are doing a lace wig, do not give up when you feel like you have hit a wall, because I wanted to pull it off my head and start all over. But I think it was the hairline that was driving me nuts. It was just way too straight. But it was too straight for me. So what I really did was I just had to go in and work some magic. That's where baby hairs come into play. A lot of people be like, oh my God, no baby hairs. But sometimes you gotta scoop them hairs out in order to make the front look a little bit more nice, like, you know. And some wigs are easier to deal with than others. Not saying this one isn't, it's just that sometimes some laces are different than other laces. So at this point, I was just like, listen, I was like, what? But it came out good towards the end, guys. So never give up, just keep going. I am a prime example, because a lot of times I'm experimenting on camera for you guys, so you guys can see the full thing. And I think me being a little bit too real sometimes does backfire, because I will get everyone in the comments like cursing me out, coming back at me like, girl, you don't know what you're doing, you doing the wrong thing, blah blah blah. But it's really just to show you guys that things happen in real life. Like, at the end of the day, my result was good, you know what I'm saying? So just take your time, take a break, take a chill pill, have a drink, take time doing your hair. But new techniques are gonna always be hard the first time, and then after it gets better, because I was like, at this point I was getting a little bit more happy. I was like, ah, it's working, it is working. But at first I was like, okay, chill out, Simone, like, I don't know what's about to happen. But it just takes time. My part looks freaking amazing, I'm not gonna lie. So would I try this method again? I would definitely try this method again, because like I said, I might have looked like my ceiling was missing, but it looks really good. And I think it looks really good. And I feel like it really just brought out more color into my part and made it stand out a little bit more. So my camera died. So off camera, I went ahead and I cut my hair a little bit. I just used the razor looking comb. I just trimmed the front a little bit and kind of just layered it a little bit. And now I'm just using some setting foam to kind of set the hairs. But it just takes time, y'all. Like, don't give up. And this was my end result. I curled it and everything off camera, and I think it looks freaking amazing. So would I try this again? I would most likely try this again, but I'm pretty sure someone else has done it. I'm not sure who has, but for me, being my first time trying it, I absolutely loved my result, and I would definitely try it again. It was very comfortable, okay? I almost forgot I had it on. When I took my wig off, I was like, wait, where is my braids? Like, I forgot I had it on, but it does make a difference, and it does feel really nice on your hair. You cannot see it through your lace. So this one is a thumbs up for me, and I suggest you guys try as well. This is my end result. My outfit that you're about to see was from Fashion Nova, top, bottom, and shoes. I will have that try-on haul coming on soon, but I absolutely loved my end result, and this hair color from Diva Lace Wigs was amazing. Like, Diva Wigs was amazing. I absolutely love Diva Wigs. I've worked with them several times, and the hair texture is always a silky nice and silky texture. Like, it just slips through your fingers. This wig was very full, I will say, but I absolutely loved it. Loved it. Everything is in the description box, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.